Mr. Joe Buscaino, the floor is yours, sir.
Thank you, Mr. President. It's great to declare the month of October Italian Heritage Month. Go ahead, guys.
So what did you say? Let's give it a round of applause. We're going to declare this month. Let's go. Yeah.
Allora, oggi siamo tutti italiani. We are all Italian today, ladies and gentlemen, colleagues. And before we kick off our festivities, we are going to begin the program with the singing of our national anthem. All rise, please stand. To sing the Italian National Anthem, help me welcome students from Franklin Magnet Elementary School. Yes.
Joe, you see how they look on the screen so they can,
yeah,
see,
they can
themselves.
See themselves. Yes. Allora, siamo pronti? Quasi. Okay, Ken.
Non c'è la musica. Ivan. Non c'è la musica. Seguire. Chiaro?
Siamo pronti? Musica?
No musica.
No musica, va bene. A cappella. Okay, a cappella. Here we go.
Fra. Fratelli. L'Italia, l'Italia se desta, bell'elmo di Scipio, se cinta la testa, dove la vittoria che porta la chioma che schiama di Roma, che Dio la creò. Fratelli d'Italia, l'Italia se desta, dell'elmo di Scipio se cinta la testa, dov'è la vittoria?
Thank you. Wonderful. How beautiful. How beautiful was that, colleagues? Students from San Pedro of Italian descent singing the national anthem, and students from Franklin Magnet Elementary School, most who are not of Italian descent, singing the Italian national anthem. Was that beautiful or what? Bravi. Thank you, Mr. President and colleagues. Of course, we think of Italy, we think of art and music and culture and food and the significant contributions Italians have made, not only to the city, but also to this country. I'd like to welcome Miss Janet DeMay from Casa Italiana Opera House to kick off the festivities with a wonderful, wonderful opera song. Miss DeMay. Janet DeMay, thank you so much, Ms. DeMay. Appreciate you. Allora, ancora una volta sono onorato di chiedere questo mese, il mese dei eredità italiana-americana. I'm proud again to declare this month Italian-American Heritage Month in the city of Los Angeles. Colleagues, each and every year, the President of the United States signs an executive order designating the month of October as National Italian Heritage Month, which recognizes the many achievements and contributions of Americans of Italian descent, as well as of Italians in America. Over 5.4 million Italians immigrated to the United States from 1820 to 1992, and today there are over 26 million Americans of Italian descent in the United States, making them the fifth largest ethnic group. As is always stated in these John Ferraro Council chambers, as John Ferraro is smiling down upon us today, one of our greatest city strength is its diversity. And that's why it's important that we not only remember our roots, but nourish and harness them. And during council recess this last week, I spent the week traveling the homeland where my parents migrated from. That's Sicily. There, I spent time meeting with mayors of Sicilian cities in Bagheria, Trapeto, Terracini, Chinisi, and San Vito Lo Capo, dignitaries and officials of the port of Palermo, where we discussed our respective local policy issues, our respective solutions to those issues, and planned future collaborations, specifically working on establishing a friendship port relationship with the port of Palermo. Through the California National League of Cities, where we share ideas on how to solve various problems, we can also share ideas from cities abroad, thus tapping into our historic and cultural roots to not only help us figure out where we come from, but also brainstorm on how to fix our problems and move forward using our history and roots. When we work with cities abroad, we foster international trade and therefore take advantage of the economic activity, especially when we have the busiest port here of North America, the Port of Los Angeles. And this is why we declare October Italian Heritage Month in the city of Los Angeles. I've invited a number of key individuals here to speak, including our Consul General, who I will soon bring up. But the one individual that I want to recognize is my bride, we'll be celebrating 15 years tomorrow. My wife, Jay Buscaino. And with all due respect, Mr. Koretz, she is my favorite karaoke partner today. Mr. Antonio Verdi, our Italian Consul General of Los Angeles, his jurisdiction, colleagues, includes Arizona, Nevada, New Mexico. Mr. Verdi's experience spans a diversity of sectors, including banking and publishing, and whose public foreign services include assignments in Tokyo, Moscow, Australia, not to mention fields such as energy and environment and immigration. Here in Los Angeles, Mr. Antonio Verdi has dedicated his time and work to fostering strong relationships between the Italian Consul and other local Italian institutions, such as the Italian Trade Agency, the Italian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, the Italian Cultural Institute, and other key stakeholders, such as the Tourism Board. He is also committed to increasing Italian language and culture instruction at our local schools here in Los Angeles. And by having a strong emphasis on establishing and nourishing relationships between local Italian cultural and business organizations, and by introducing Italian culture to our youth, we create economic activity between our city here and cities throughout Italy and the rest of the Mediterranean. Come si dice, quando lavoriamo insieme, rafforziamo le nostre forze e riduciamo al minimo le nostre debolezze. Con rapporti culturali e commerciali, possiamo crescere insieme le nostre proprie industrie. And just like I told the mayors in Sicily, when we work together, we strengthen our strengths and minimize our weaknesses. With cultural and commercial relationships, we can grow together our respective industries. Help me welcome our Italian Consul General, Antonio Verdi.
Council members, ladies and gentlemen, the proclamation of October as Italian Heritage Month in Los Angeles is a well-deserved recognition of Americans of Italian descent and of their contribution to the growth and development of this great city since its earliest days. And we thank Councilman Buscaino for bringing this about, since it also allies the key influence Italian culture and lifestyle have historically exerted in this part of the world. Dedicating this month to the celebration of the Italian heritage is extremely meaningful for the Italian and Italian-American communities, since it symbolizes the commitment of the City of Los Angeles to honoring their heritage, history, and culture. The proclamation also expresses the relationship of respect, friendship, and cooperation existing between Italy and Los Angeles. Fostering these ties is the primary mission of the Consulate General of Italy and all the Italian institutions in Los Angeles, from the Cultural Institute to the Trade Commission to the Italian Tourist Board to the American Chamber of Commerce. During this coming month, the Greater Los Angeles will be home to a series of high-profile events to celebrate the role of Italian culture in the historical framework of this country's growth and development, and the uninterrupted flow of creativity that continues to characterize its culture. For example, on October 10, beautiful Pico House will host the Taste of Italy, and of course, Columbus Day celebration are a precious opportunity to remember the role that Italians have played in making the city of Los Angeles the modern and open metropolis we know and love. And in neighboring Santa Monica, a month-long celebration showcasing the best of Italian culture, including fashion, food, art, and music called Ciao Italia, has just started. On the 17th, we'll bring you at broad stage a salute to Frank Sinatra's 500th birthday, hosted by Barbara Sinatra. I hope you will join us and look forward to see you there. Thank you very much for your attention, and thank you very much for honoring Italy with this Heritage Month. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Verdi. Grazie. Thank you. Grazie mille. Colleagues, we will honor three individuals who have made significant contributions to the Italian-American community as it relates to preserving the Italian heritage culture here in the city of Los Angeles. Our first honoree is the Executive Director of the Italian-American Museum of Los Angeles, also known as IMLA, a historian, an author, an advocate, a nonprofit leader, and a dear friend, Miss Mariana Gatto. Can we bring her up, please? Okay, it's okay. And Damiano. Damiano, vieni. Joining Ms. Gatto is her son, Damian, and also the board president of the Italian American Museum, Mr. Paul Pagnoni. But colleagues and Mr. President, if I may, before I continue reading Mariana's bio and achievements, I can think of no better way to show our appreciation to her and the entire board and the efforts made by preserving and putting together this incredible Italian museum by taking up item number 27 on today's agenda, which we know Mariana has worked tirelessly on for many, many months. If we can take item 27.
Item 27 is now before us.
Colleagues, item 27 is an Arts and Parks River Committee report. Thank you for your leadership, Mr. O'Farrell, for hearing this in your committee, and also to Mr. Wizar, whose district includes the Italian Museum. Thank you for your commitment, Mr. Wizar, for embracing and supporting the Italian American Museum, the Italian Hall. This item before us, recommending the approval of a 10-year lease agreement with the Italian American Museum of Los Angeles, with three 10-year renewal options for space at the Italian Hall building in El Pueblo. Over $2 million has already been raised and expended by the nonprofit Historic Italian Hall Federation for the renovation, improvements, and maintenance of the museum and the Italian Hall building, and they have committed to raising an additional $500,000 in the initial 10-year period and $500,000 during each renewal option period for improvements, exhibits, and artifacts. I also like to recognize from the Pueblo Commission, Commissioner Sal DiCostanzo, who's here, who's actually videotaping. Thank you, Commissioner. And of course, our general manager, Chris Espinosa. Thank you, Mr. Espinosa, for your leadership. So colleagues, I ask that we support item 27 before us. I ask for an aye vote.
Okay, Mr. Cedillo.
I rise obviously to support this. There is incredible leadership. Maringato is the most appropriate person that you could select to be honored on this. You mentioned that there were $2 million raised and spent, and I want to give credit to the great, with all due respect to Mr. Ferraro, the great Italian of the city, yes. Joe Sorrell. Yes. You remember this, Mr. Speaker. Joe Sorrell was a frequent visitor of the Assembly and had heard of our efforts to fund the Chinese Museum. And we had the legislation ready to go to fund the Chinese Museum. We're going to give them $1 million. And so Joe Sorrell and his great skill of lobbying and his humble way comes up, much like you, with his hands crossed like that, his head down, and said, you know, I hear you're giving $1 million to the Chinese Museum. And he said, yes, Joe, we work very hard. We're very excited about that. And he says, you know, gee, I wish you could give $1 million to the Italian Museum. You know, we've got all this work to do, and we've got to restore it and protect it. And I said, well, Joe, that's great, but, you know, it's kind of late in the session, and we're at the end, and it's, you know, we really want to move this. And he said, well, Gil, you know, I really would appreciate it if you could do this. So in his humble way, as Joe was, we gave it a shot. And so we put another $1 million in the proposal, and we called it the Marco Polo. And we said, only in America and only in downtown Los Angeles and only at El Pueblo could we unite all these communities together. And could we have legislation that talked about how the Italians went to China and where pasta came from and then how they all ended up in downtown Los Angeles. All that is part of the rich history. It's the precursor, the historical precursor for these communities coming together. And you're right, Mr. Buscaino, diversity is our strength. And no, there's no place more emblematic of that diversity than El Pueblo. And so it's so appropriate for you to honor Ms. Gatto for her incredible leadership and the Italian Hall and its leadership. So congratulations. And Mr. President, I speak in honor of the motion, in favor of the motion.
Oh. And you passed it.
Okay, Mr. Wizar.
Thank you, Mr. President. What a great presentation, Mr. Buscaino. We know that how incredibly important it is for you to talk about your Italian roots, and it's great to see that now, with an Italian-American here in Council once again, we continue to fulfill these chambers with Italians from all walks of life. But to have you feel that pride and joy of being an Italian, we couldn't have a better representative on this council than you, Mr. Buscaino. And Ms. Gatto, congratulations to you. You know, you along with Mr. Pagnoni and the board at the Italian American Hall have single-handedly brought back a project that many people thought would not happen. When I first got elected in 2005, I heard about how the old dilapidated museum was just sitting there rotting away, and not only not fulfilling its promise about bringing back and talking to people about the heritage of Italians in Los Angeles, but the history of Los Angeles itself, right, and people who built this great city. So congratulations to you. Wonderful, wonderful recognition. And I recall back in budget and finance, we were able to allocate about $2 million to start the effort. It's great to see that it continues through fundraising efforts. That was the idea all along, that if the city put some money in to start the capital improvements, that the private sector would step up and continue the project, and we were able to do that. So congratulations to you, to all your board. Wonderful, wonderful job. Congratulations.
Mr. Rue.
My brother from another mother.
You know, thank you so much
We're all related, right?
Thank you so much for such a wonderful a presentation today, and it just livened up the mood here at City Hall. And I see your parents there, and I went to go say hi, and I was afraid they were going to take me to the side and offer me some beverages.
Limoncello, right.
Yeah. And but, you know, as an immigrant, you know, it's so great when we share the diversity in our cultures and our roots. You know, Los Angeles is made up of immigrants. United States is made up of immigrants, and it's about sharing and learning from each other. And, you know, not only do we have numerous links, we also have another. I have the fortunate opportunity to continue the legacy of Councilmember John Ferraro.
Right.
And I take that to heart, and we're inextricably linked. And thank you so much for this presentation today, and thank you, and congratulations to the Italian American community.
Right.
Back to you, Mr. Buscaino.
Fantastic. If we can take item 27, again, I ask for an aye vote and hope we can get unanimous approval of this item before us.
Okay, Madam Clerk, please open the roll. Close the roll. Tabulate the vote. 15 ayes, that is approved. Forthwith. Mr.
Yes,
Buscaino.
Sir. Thank you.
Fourth
How appropriate.
With.
Mariana Gatto's grandparents fled from poverty and social inequality in Calabria and Sicily in the early part of the 20th century. Her grandfather was a steel worker and laborer, and her grandmother was a sweatshop worker. They settled in Lincoln Heights, which at the time was Los Angeles' Little Italy. Mariana's father, God rest his soul, Joseph Gatto, taught her the importance of education and appreciation of her Italian roots. Mariana has lived in Los Angeles all her life, born and raised in the Silver Lake and Los Feliz area. She attended UCLA, Cal State LA, and graduated magna cum laude in social science and history. She then got her teaching credential in secondary education and a master's in history. She turned down the opportunity to teach at an exclusive private school to teach students in Skid Row. She has also served as a curator of history and education for the City of Los Angeles and has produced many acclaimed exhibitions, including the one we brought down to San Pedro, Sunshine, Struggle to Sunshine. Sunshine to Struggle, I remember that. And that's where she met her husband. I take credit for that. Mariana is responsible for over $1 million of allocation of city funding and over $1 million privately raised for the Italian American Museum project. She has drastically enhanced the museum's collection and created its signature annual event, The Taste of Italy, this Saturday. I know Mr. O'Farrell, we'll see you there. Hoping you all can join us. Mariana Gatto enhances the knowledge of Italian history through community involvement and through her research publications. Help me honor Mariana Gatto as one of this year's Italian Heritage Month honorees.
Thank you and good morning. Essentially, what I'm being recognized this morning for is doing what I love. And that's a very great feeling, memorializing the lives of others. So thank you, Councilmember Buscaino, for this recognition. I'd also like to acknowledge my son, Damien, who for the past 21 years of his life has inspired me to be a better person. And I'd like to dedicate this award to my grandparents, who faced pretty awful treatment in this country when they first arrived, like many immigrants past and present, but their struggles made my life, our lives, possible. And that's pretty much it. We're so happy to work with you on the museum project and bring the multi-layered history of our city to the masses. The museum is not simply for or about Italian Americans, but really a loving tribute to our region's diverse roots. So thank you so much.
Okay, Trainee family, come on up. Thank you. Congratulations. The Trainee family, amazing family with us today from San Pedro. Classic Italian-American immigrant success story. Filippo Trainee arrived at Ellis Island on August 25th, 1913, at the age of 18. Fantastic. From the Italian central coast island of Ischia, which is our sister city in Italy. He farmed and fished for years until he was able to open up the iconic and legendary Majestic Cafe in 1925, where he fed everyone from dock workers to celebrities. The restaurant became a family heirloom when, in 1937, Filippo Trainee's son joined him in operating the restaurant. After the original Majestic closed in 1989, son Jim Trainee opened J. Trainee's in San Pedro, and among its regulars was Tommy Lasorda. Dustin Trainee, a fixture at J. Trainee's since the age of six, influenced by his grandfather Jim Trainee Sr. and his father Jim Trainee Jr., started cooking at an early age by learning the family's secret recipe. Dustin also studied in the Italian truffle region, trained by the Oriental Hotel in Bangkok, Thailand, and was a chef at the People's Cafe in Zagreb, Croatia. He is now an award-winning chef here in Los Angeles. Phil Trainee Jr., son of Filippo, also has a great location in Long Beach, which has been there now for 25 years. The restaurant has hosted numerous professional athletes, coaches, sports writers, including Tommy Lasorda, Jerry West, John Wooden, Bill Sharman, and Mark Sanchez, among others. This year, J. Trainee's restaurant in San Pedro celebrated its 90th year. Help me welcome and introduce and acknowledge the Trainee family. Come on, Rocco. Come here, attaboy. Yeah. And joining us, the newest generation of the Trainee family, Rocco Trainee. I love that kid. Look at him. Okay, want to say a few words?
Who wants to speak?
Good to see you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for having us here today. On behalf of the entire Trainee family, we would love to thank the city of San Pedro, the city of Long Beach, and the entire county for embracing our family and allowing us to live the American dream. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good job.
And last but most definitely not least, we have with us today Mr. David Cristofaro, who is the Executive Vice President and Lead Region President for Wells Fargo Bank, overseeing 268 stores and more than 5,000 team members, and serves customers across Los Angeles, San Bernardino, Riverside counties throughout the Coachella Valley. Before entering and climbing the ladder in the banking industry, Mr. DeCristofaro grew up in the Bronx of New York City, where he attended a predominantly Italian school, St. Teresa Elementary School. His father migrated to North America in 1958 in the region of Molise. His mother migrated from the Avellino province in the Campania region. Mr. DeCristofaro contributes to the culture and community of the LA region by serving as board chair of the Pasadena Playhouse, vice chairman of the American Red Cross of Greater LA, and also is a huge supporter of the Italian American Museum of Los Angeles. Help me recognize Mr. David DeCristofaro.
Thank you. Appreciate that. All right.
So first of all, thank you to President Wesson, the City Council, and especially Councilman Buscaino for this tremendous recognition. To be honored as an Italian of distinction in Los Angeles is so very special to me. As the son of immigrant Italians, I can't express how incredibly meaningful it is to be recognized today. I'm so appreciative of this honor. I also want to thank and acknowledge our fellow honorees today, Mariana Gatto. Congratulations, thanks for everything you do, and looking forward to Taste of Italy on Saturday, as well as the Trani family for all of the great work you do in bringing delicious Italian cuisine to Southern California for so long. Also want to thank and acknowledge my friends and family that are here today, so thank you all for being here. I also want to take a moment to especially thank my parents, my family. They could not be here today. They're back in New York. I can tell you it was incredibly painful for my mom to not be here, but unfortunately she could not make it. Now, my good friend and colleague, who I think many of you know, Jonathan Weidman, he likes to say there are two types of people in the world, those who are Italian and those who want to be Italian. Yes, and boy is he right. I just returned from my first trip this past September to Italy, and this joke has renewed meaning for me. I had the opportunity to visit Amalfi, Rome, Tuscany, Florence, amazing cities with incredible food, incredible sights to see. I was just blown away by how incredible it was. The people and the culture were even more vibrant than I expected. But without question, the visit to my parents' towns was the most important and impactful, memorable part of the trip. My father is originally from a very small town of fewer than 300 people called San Stefano, a small city outside of Cambobas in the region of Molise. My mother is from another very small part of Italy called Cerinaria, in an area called city called Avellino in the province of Campania. Strolling through their hometowns and witnessing their tiny gray stone dilapidated structures where they grew up, they had a pig pen next door, seeing the fields where my grandfather would tend the sheep in the morning and throughout the day, I could not help but develop a renewed appreciation for the journey that they started in 1958 that took them from their small Italian towns to New York City with the hope of building a better life for themselves and their family. My trip gave me a new sense of the perspective of where my family came from, but quite frankly, all of our families came from, whether we're Italian or simply one of those that aspires to be Italian, and what it really means to have the courage to leave our homeland in search of greater prosperity. It is amazing that we live in a country where the sons of two Italian immigrants who came to this city with literally nothing can work his way up to become Wells Fargo's president of Greater Los Angeles and stand in the council of the city of Los Angeles and be recognized by our esteemed city council, something we should all be proud of. This is truly a country of great opportunity, and it is incumbent on all of us to honor this by giving back to the communities in which we live and work. That is why I am so thankful for the ability to work for Wells Fargo, a company that truly cares for our communities and values diversity. I like to say Wells Fargo is the leading corporate citizen in Los Angeles, and I'm proud to say that Wells Fargo has been named the top corporate philanthropist for the last 10 years by the LA Business Journal, and annually our team members volunteer more than 30,000 hours of community service each year. At Wells Fargo, we know we can only be as strong as the strength of our community, and today I humbly and gratefully accept this wonderful award on behalf of our amazing community, my caring company, my courageous family, and the many daring immigrants who came to this country in search of greater opportunity each year. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Congratulations. Thank you. Colleagues, I'd like to introduce our very own Italian-American here in the city family. Our very own LAPD captain in Mr. Wesson's district, Captain Vito Palazzolo di Teresini.
Hey, Cap.
Also, Councilwoman Nuri Martinez, Chief of Staff. I love the red, white, the Italian band there representing the Chief of Staff, Channel 35, we gotta get a shot of that. Mr. Jim D'Antona. There you go, stay put, stay put. There he is, really proud. We can't forget also an Italian American, my colleague, Mike Bonin. Did you know that his mom Beth Constantino is Italian as well. Mike, please stand and take a bow representing the Italian-American community. Your mom's not here. She is here in spirit.
Missing the Italian Fest this weekend because I will be back on the East Coast with her eating, sorry folks, the best meatballs and and tomato sauce in the world.
All right. Also, let's be reminded that Mayor Garcetti's great-grandparents immigrated from Italy to Mexico, and I believe he may be joining us a little bit later. In addition, I'd like to recognize Florentino Blastolino, who is our trade commissioner. Thank you so much for joining us. Looking forward to working with you to establish better relationships between our respective countries as it relates to trade and commerce and science and technology. We're gonna do great work in the year ahead. Also, a number of Italian organizations joining us here, Federated Italo-Americans of Southern California, the Trappetto Club of San Pedro, the National Italian American Foundation, Italian American Museum of Los Angeles, the Italy America Chamber of Commerce, the Feast of San Gennaro, the Italian American Club of San Pedro, Casa Italiana Opera House, the Sister City of Ischia Foundation, the Italian Catholic Federated Branch 115. And we'd like to close, colleagues, this year's Italian Heritage Month Council presentation with the performance of students from the San Pedro area.
If I may.
Yes.
If I just may interrupt for a second for two quick things. I do want to acknowledge a former assemblyman and a friend of many of us here, former assemblyman Anthony Portantino. We should give him a round of applause. And I know, I think I shared this story with you, Mr. Buscaino, but I feel compelled to share it again. I went to a Catholic high school in Cleveland, Ohio, at a time when there were serious problems, there were racial issues very similar to a lot of the racial issues that we have in some parts of the country today. For the first two and a half weeks that I went to school at 5'5", 105 pounds, I got jumped on and beat up every day.
Wow.
Every day, to the point where it was so bad that one of my buddies' fathers owned a barbershop. He gave me a straight razor to take to school because I was not going to get beaten again. And as I was going home, again, I was surrounded by a group of guys that were gonna beat me up. I reached in my pocket because I was not gonna just, I fought every time, but this time I was just not gonna go down without really injuring somebody. And then, like in a movie, there was a voice that came from nowhere indicating that from this moment on, that Herb Wesson was an honorary son of Italy. No, and that if you mess with him, you mess with us. And I never, ever, ever had a problem.
Let that be true today. If you mess with Herb, you mess with us.
Well, but what it was, it just showed a group of guys that thought it was stupid, and we became friends. And I just want to know that I don't know where my life would have been if it weren't for them coming in and at that point in time. I surely may not be sitting before you today. So I do feel like I'm an honorary son.
Yes, sir, you are.
And I think this is a great day. And I think we should give another round of applause for a group of people that helped shape
this country. Thank you, Mr. President and colleagues. And before, as the kids are setting up, I do want to recognize my mom and dad who are here, my sister, my mother-in-law, my brother-in-law and sister-in-law, my aunts and uncles and cousins.
Let's give them a round of applause.
It's a family affair here. We love you.
Love you guys.
Okay, this is our closing song. And you know it, sing along, Mr. Kretz, if you know it.
When boys
Gia?
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing me.
Let's hear it for Rich Deanna, true, out of Chicago, but has San Pedro in his heart. Thank you, Rich. We love you. He is San Pedro's Billy Joe, right, Jay? So don't forget this Saturday, Taste of Italy, and our Buscaino block party spaghetti dinner on Sunday, October 11th at Weymouth Corners, noon to 4. Colleagues, you've all been invited. Please bring your friends and family. Free event on Sunday in San Pedro. Thank you so much. A number of individuals that helped put today's event together, and some program going on throughout the month in the entire region. Ann Potenza, Marcella Tyler, Emanuele Bonibianco, Frankie Capitelli, Josephine Shimataro, Mariana Gatto, Hector Garcia of Farmer John's, Paul Galletti of Southwind Foods, Janet DeMay, Rich Deanna, of course, Antonella Hartel Ventura, of students at Franklin, Umberto Bonfante for the espresso, and Dustin Traney from Dona. Thank you so much. God bless you, and thank you for joining us. There's a lunch reception. Everyone's invited at the forecourt. Everyone's invited at the lunch reception following the presentation. Thank you, Mr. President.
All right. Well done, Mr. Buscaino, and congratulations.
Thank you.
We'll go.